Hey.
We are not ignorant that Kenya is going through a hard situation. I think today is the highest. I saw the CS talk about 123 people infected in the last 24 hours, and that is a very high number. This tells me that God is calling us to wake up, and as we take precaution, we also pray God to continue releasing his mercies upon this nation and also the world. But no temptation that comes unto us, and the Lord fails to provide a way for us. I'm very sure there is going to be a way out. That is why we continue to preach up, to speak up to all the people. Because when you lose hope, then things begin to go wrong. The faith we have in God continues to give us a lot of hope, and we are hopeful that the thing is going to cool down and life is going to continue normally. We are still in the month of grace. May was a month of grace. And this week, I promised that we are going to do another series which is going to leave you very different. And I want to start today, God willing, continue on Friday and possibly close it on Sunday, God willing. So you don't have to miss any of these series, because we chose to be teaching. When we teach, people learn. When people learn, they change, and the word begins to work in their lives. Allow me to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for giving us yet another day of coming to share your word. Thank you for our viewers who have joined us from all over this nation and elsewhere. Thank you for the crew which has been doing the work here at the ground. We are praying for each viewer, wherever they are. Lord, we ask you to bless them. We ask you to minister goodness to them. And Lord, to meet them at the point of need. Help me, Jehovah God, to deliver your will, to speak your will, because I am only a vessel. And what I say is what you intend to say to your people. Be with us. When we see ourselves closing, we will thank you and honor your name. In Jesus' name, we do pray and believe. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We are starting on engaging the power of dominion. Engaging the power of dominion. That is going to be our topic and our series between now and Sunday. Friday we are here again at 4, and on Sunday we are here at 11. Engaging the power of dominion. There is a reason why we chose to frame the topic like that. Because you can have dominion, but you fail to engage the power. Our aim is that by the time we are completing this series, somebody will have been transformed and realized whom they are and began to engage that power which is God given, the power of dominion. I'll be explaining the meaning of some of the terms as we continue, but wherever you are, you can get your pen and paper or your iPad or wherever you write notes and pick some few things which can help you. We will not mind if you teach the word again to go and teach what we are teaching in a better way elsewhere so that other people can be blessed. Our key text is Ephesians chapter 1 verse 18 to 23. Ephesians 1, 18 to 23. And at your own time, you can read from verse 15, but for my purpose, I want to start from verse 18. Paul says, I pray also that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints. Let me say something about that verse. This was the prayer of David, of Paul, sorry, to the church of Ephesus, that their eyes of the heart be enlightened. This tells us that we have some other eyes, not the ones we see, but the eyes of the heart. And unless the eyes of the heart are enlightened, then people may not know some few things. Like here we are told, so that you may know the hope to which he has called you and the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints. There are things you can never know until there is some enlightenment in your heart. Allow me to look at amplified version of the same verse. Amplified version. It says, and so that you can know and understand. So, knowledge and understanding about some few things concerning our lives is very important. And he says, what is the immeasurable and unlimited and surpassing greatness of his power in and out of us who believe, is demonstrated in the working of his mighty strength. This is the kind of understanding that Paul wanted the Ephesian church to understand, to know that there is immeasurable and unlimited surpassing greatness of his power. This verse 19 is talking about the great power, the great dominion power that has been given to the church, to the children of God, which is not limited. It is surpassing greatness for those who believe, as demonstrated in the working of his mighty strength. 20, verse 20. The Bible says, which he exalted in Christ when he raised him from the dead. I remember when I was doing the virtual service here on the Resurrection Sunday, I talked about the power of the resurrection. So this power was released, exalted in Christ when he raised from the dead. And guess where he is sitting? And is seated at his own right hand in the heavenly places. Later, before I finish, I will mention something concerning that. So where he is sitting with a lot of power which can be delegated to the children of God. Verse 21. For above all rule and authority and power and dominion and every name that is named, above every title that can be conferred, not only in this age and in this world, but also in the age and the world which is to come. Ladies and gentlemen, this kind of dominion is for this age. For us, this power is for us now and even in the world to come. The heavenlies, the authority, the rulership, the dominion which is in this name is above every other dominion. Verse 22. That is where you see now the source of this power. And he has put all things under his feet and has appointed him the universal and the supreme head of the church, a headship exercised throughout the church. This is a power that was conferred unto Jesus when he rose from the dead. All things were put under him. And I want you to know that if they are under him and we inherit with him, then every other thing, including what is happening today, is also under our feet. Because everything was put under Jesus by God, which means even for us, everything is under us. The universal and the supreme head of the church, a headship exercised throughout the church. If in any way you have a connection with the church, some authority, some dominion has been put in your life, you can dominate, you can rule, you can exercise this important power. And lastly, verse 23, the Bible says, which is his body. Now the church is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in them. For in that body lives the full measure of him who makes everything complete and who fills everything everywhere with himself. I wish we can comprehend this, that in this body of Christ, the fullness of him, the fullness of Christ fills all in all. For in that body lives the full measure of him. So the full measure of Christ is in the church. Amen. When you get to understand this thing, then you can cause things to happen. You can stop to fear, because the Bible says he also makes everything complete. With him, you have everything, and he fills everything everywhere with himself. Everything everywhere is filled with himself, which means you cannot go somewhere and say Christ is not here. He fills everything with himself. Can I hear somebody say amen to that? Amen. So the source of our dominion is God, delegated or put under Jesus. And Jesus is the head of the church. So we are authorized to rule and to serve with full power and dominion. So the world exercises dominion using force. But us Christians, or Christ, exercises his power through service. When we are serving the way we are serving today, we are exercising that power which comes from God, which is also dominion. Let me define this term called dominion. Dominion in the simplest terms, is a form of power or authority or control over something. That is the simplest. A form of power, authority, or control over something or someone. If you can have power and authority and control over something or someone, you are exercising dominion. I want you to check yourself as a man of God, as a woman of God, and see how far you have exercised power, you have exercised authority, you have exercised control. Because all said and done, the church has to exercise power, it has to exercise authority, it has to exercise control. I know pastors have been abused. That why are they not using this power to do ABCD? But I want to confirm still that Christ is still the leader of the church. He is exercising power, authority, and control over everything and over Satan himself. Nothing can conquer Christ. And Christ is the head of the church. And can I say, the church has not been defeated. I wish I had a witness. The church is not defeated. Jesus said, I will build my church on this rock, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. And I kept confirm that no gate of hell is going to prevail. If COVID-19 is a gate of hell, it shall not prevail over the church. Can somebody shout amen? It shall not prevail, because already the church is built under Christ. Dominion is also the ability to command. That ability to command and expect fulfillment of the appeal. The ability to command. You are commanding. And what you command, you expect fulfillment of that appeal. Wherever you are watching me from, I want you to know that you can command. And when you command, what you are commanding, you don't command without expectation. You expect fulfillment of the appeal that you make to the heavens. When you get this introduction, you are going to operate at a different level. When every other person is living under fear, you are going to operate under serious dominion and a serious command. I send you today, I commission you today to go and command things and wait for fulfillment of that one which you command. I continue to say a few things, statements about dominion. To have dominion is to rule and to be in charge. To have dominion is to rule and to be in charge. We are releasing people from this teaching to go and rule. You can't come out of it. You can't come out of this service and you fail to go and rule. We are releasing people to go out there and rule and also be in charge. If you cannot be in charge, then you have no dominion. There is need for somebody to know they are in charge. That is why we are here today, to declare that We have dominion. We are in charge. We are exercising the power of dominion. We are engaging the power of ruling. I continue to make more statements. Spiritual dominion, because we have what we call spiritual dominion, falls under the auspices of God. God is the host of spiritual dominion. Apart from delegating this to man, he is the one who is hosting issues of spiritual dominion. But us as men, we take it because we are his children through salvation. So the same power which God exercises in the spiritual realms, we can also exercise it as a child. And it is effective when we totally submit to the will of God. If God is the host, then there is need for us also to submit to his will so that we can exercise the power of this dominion. And I want to say that dominion is about knowing who we are in Christ. When you get to know yourself, your position as a son, as a child of God, that you are an inheritor together with Jesus, then when you understand yourself, you can begin to exercise dominion. It is knowing that through him who has the power, you can lay hold of the promises of God. Dominion gives you another level where you can move and lay hold of the promises of God. And I want to say that the promises of God are not there for the sake. They are there for the children of God who have dominion. We can't leave them in the shelves. We can't leave healing in the shelves. Long life in the shelves. We can't leave it. Prosperity. We can't leave it. You know, living in power. We can't leave it. The promises are for us, for our taking, because we normally operate under dominion. With that kind of introduction, ladies and gentlemen, I believe somebody can walk from it and go and begin to exercise authority. The thing that has been sitting on you, the thing that is sitting on the church, you can move ahead and begin to deal with it. You cannot come out of this teaching and go to operate under fear, to talk to the spiritual world like you are fearing. You need to go there with boldness and confidence and exercise that power of dominion as much as you can. Have what God says you can, and be what God says you can. Let me quote somebody who said, "Nothing is more gratifying to the mind of man than power or dominion." Nothing is more gratifying to the mind of man than power or dominion. When you know that you have power, you are gratified. Your heart is fulfilled. When you know that you have dominion, you are full of power. There is nothing that compares to that kind of force. When you know for sure you have power or dominion, you are really gratified. And we are releasing you today to go and exercise this authority. That was introduction. Now I want to deal with understanding the concept of dominion. Understanding the concept of dominion. dominion. Today I bring two areas or two issues in understanding the concept of dominion. Number one, dominion was commanded by God. Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, KJV. Dominion was commanded by God. So the first commander of dominion is God. And I feel like releasing this thing over your life. The Bible says, and God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth over the earth. That was the command of God to man. As man continued to multiply and become fruitful and subdue, defeat the earth, he was commanded, go and have dominion. And as good as you watch this message, to ask yourself, how far has the human race dominated? How far have we gone in dominating? Quite a number of things have happened. And I think it's good to go back to the roots and find out how we can begin to operate under dominion. So it is a command that was given by God. When man was made in the image of God, in the likeness of God, the other thing that was done was a command to dominate. And I want you to know, you are that man. Because we cannot now talk about Adam. It is us who have been given this command to dominate. And I want to say, God has given us dominion. He created us to rule over everything. Sometimes the devil behaves like he can rule over us until we lack or some things like they belong to the devil. We call some parts black spots. We give them names like it is a dominant place of the enemy, the devil. What I know, the devil is called the king of the world, but he has no dominion over the works of creation. Whatever God created is under God, and the God dominates the creation. You are a creation of God, and through Jesus Christ, you were delegated with the power to dominate. And initially, this dominion was lost in Genesis chapter 3 when man fell into sin. But God did not allow it to continue. There was a temporary solution whereby there were rules and regulations and commandments, you know, governing repentance, governing how man can go back to God. But later, a one-time sacrifice was given. And mark this word, a one-time sacrifice was given. There was the old Adam, and then now there is the new Adam, who came and died on the cross, and he restored dominion for the church, which is the New Testament church. We are now living in the time of the New Testament, and Christ has restored that power of dominion. What is the solution? We need to plug to the source. The source is God. When we connect to the source, we bridge the gap between man and God. Automatically, we receive our dominion. So you are a son by adoption through the power of the cross. And the power that God has. That dominion comes back to you because of the same adoption as a son. Number two, the believer must understand their authority. We had said number one, dominion was commanded by God. But now number two, the believer must understand their authority. There are things which are due to a person. For example, a child. A son is supposed to inherit the estate of their father constitutionally. But until they know and understand, they know their right, the estate may stay there when they are suffering. I have seen children of billionaires living like paupers because they never knew the estate which belongs to them is their right. They go begging like a pauper. Why? Because they have not known. For me to qualify this, I have some few points which I just want to mention as we put them down. But the late Mills Monroe says, rulership is in our genes. Rulership is in our genes. Even if you refuse to exercise rulership or dominion, it is in your genes. I love that. Rulership, the power to rule, the power to dominate, it is already in your genes. You choose whether to exercise or to dominate or to stay without exercise. He also said, dominion is our makeup. I wish you got this. Rulership is in our genes. Dominion is our makeup. And he says, we were designed to rule the earth. That is understanding. We were designed to rule the earth because rulership is in our genes. Dominion is in our makeup. So what is remaining, the design of a man is for him to rule the earth. Why are we allowing the earth to rule us? It's time for the church to join hands and say, we are going to rule instead. We are going to dominate. We shall not be ruled by things. Even if your genes are not working now, they are that of a ruler, and your makeup is that one of dominion. So that's why number two is important. The believer must understand their authority. Please understand your authority by number A. 2:1. Jesus secured our power and authority. This is important. Jesus secured our power and authority. Mark 16:18. That authority is declared. They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. This is a kind of authority that you have. Who secured that authority? It is not you. It was secured on your behalf by Jesus. If a parent secures an inheritance for their children, they don't argue about it. They receive it by right. This authority that was secured by Jesus, we take it by right. Number two, we have authority to stand against Satan. This dominion gives us authority to stand against Satan. And I think we must raise in warfare and make the the devil understand that we know our authority. Ephesians 4:27. It says, do not give the devil a foothold, neither give place to the devil. NIV says, a foothold. We have authority. We cannot allow him to step in anywhere, in your family, in your career, in your money, in your business, in your health. Don't allow him to step in anywhere. Don't give him a foothold. And I command him today to leave your life in Jesus' mighty name. You don't have to stay with him like a friend. We refuse to give him a foothold in Jesus' name. Kenya belongs to God. Kenya belongs to God. And Jesus is the head of the church. We are not going to give the devil a foothold in the name of Jesus. Number two, three. We have authority to preach the gospel. We have authority to preach the gospel. This is found in Matthew 28:18-19, in the Great Commission. We have a mandate, we have dominion to preach the gospel. We see it in the Great Commission. Matthew 28:18-19, then Jesus came to them and said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. This is Jesus. He said, all authority in heaven, all dominion in heaven and on earth has been given to me. And then he tells them in verse 19, therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. I want to confirm, nothing, no power on earth can take our authority to preach the gospel. We have the mandate, and the gospel is the good news. Church, continue to witness wherever you are. Even when you are not coming to church, witness, preach the good news. Don't settle like another person. Your work is to preach. Let politicians also do politics. Let other people do things. And you also preach the gospel because you have the authority to do it. Number four of two. We are seated with him in high authority. Seated with him in high authority. I wish I had better words to explain this. That we are seated with Jesus in very high authorities. Then why do we feel that we are alone? Why do we behave like we are not with anybody? I came to tell you to understand your position right now as you sit at your home. I saw somebody here saying they are watching at their office in the place of work. Ladies and gentlemen, we are seated with Jesus in high places. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 and 6. Get to know where you are seated, where you are placed. Who is that person who has brought you down? You keep on saying you are nobody. Let other people proceed. I want to remind you, the Bible says, he made us alive with Christ. Even when we were dead in transgressions, it is by grace you have been saved, verse 6. And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus. Get to understand, you live in another realm when you recognize that Jesus died and he rose, and you were raised together with him. Although you are here physically, in the spiritual realm, you are commanding authority with Jesus in the heavenly places. If you understood yourself, then you will not live the way you have lived, you know, you despise yourself. You feel others are better than you. I come to confirm that a believer is seated with Christ in the heavenly realms. Number five, we have the power of God's word. We have the power of God's word to exercise authority. Aya ndio mamlaka tuko nayo. The power of God's word to exercise authority. I can't keep reading Romans 10:17, that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. This word has authority. The word is not another book. It is not a historical book. It is power of faith. It brings power. When you hear the word the first time, it is a written one. But it goes to another word, which is the rhema word, the revealed word. It keeps you walking in power. Continue to use the weapon of the word. Number six, we are ambassadors of Christ. We are ambassadors of Christ. I wish we understood this. Pastor Martin Mutula, I can see you in Mulolongo. You are an ambassador of Christ there. Wherever you are, you represent Christ. In Dubai, somebody is watching us from Dubai. Somebody, another person is watching us from America. Such people have dominion. You know, they are ambassadors. Whatever they are, from today, stand as an ambassador, because an ambassador represents a government on behalf of the president. So on behalf of God, you are representing heaven on earth. There is no other greater dominion. When you are walking around, behave like an ambassador. You are carrying something powerful. You are carrying a great authority, because you are representing heaven. When God wants to heal, He uses you. When God wants to deliver, He uses you. When God wants to open a church in a particular town, He uses you. Behave like a representative of God on earth. And number seven, we have the means to exercise authority. We have the means to exercise authority. Ephesians 6:14-18. And if you wanted to know about an ambassador, it is 2 Corinthians 5:20. So we have the means to exercise authority. Ephesians 6:14-18. We may not have time to go through all this, but what I wanted to say is that you have the weapons that you can use to fight as a man, a woman of authority. One weapon is the word of God. Another weapon is the blood of Jesus. Another weapon is the name of Jesus. Your testimony is a weapon. Prayer is a weapon. And more so, you can now wear the entire armor of God. That entire armor of a soldier in the army. You can wear it at the fight. It is so explained in Ephesians chapter 6. You can go and read. Why can't you begin to exercise authority? As I move to pray for you, more points are coming later, but now begin to exercise dominion. You are not like any other person. I want you to walk out of this meeting, wherever you are, with your shoulders up, and go and exercise dominion. Wake up at midnight and exercise dominion. Pray, command things, command bad dreams, command poverty, command sickness, command delays, command the works of the devil, destroy sorcery, destroy witchcraft, deal with opposition like you know who you are. I see people running from corner to corner, traveling to go and look for people, possibly to pray for them. Why can't you understand you yourself? You are of authority. You can pray and things can happen in the name of Jesus. Can you begin to thank God, whatever you are? Tell him you thank him for the dominion. Father, we thank you for the authority. We thank you for the power of dominion. I'm releasing this anointing for dominion upon everybody who is hearing this message, who is watching us, O Jehovah God. I speak authority. I speak dominion. I speak renewal upon their lives, O God. I release understanding. Let them begin to exercise the power as believers and do what they are supposed to do in their families, in their places of work, where they do business and where they walk around. We are taking the same dominion to deal with the power, even the power from the COVID-19, in the name of Jesus. We protect the believers under our authority and under our hearing, O Jehovah God. I pray for them that you may grant them authority. Give them to exercise the same authority with knowledge, O Jehovah God. Let them work with all knowledge, with all commitment, with all dedication as they continue to serve you. And Father God, I pray that you may reward them with the reward that cometh from heaven. I pray for you now, Father, in the name of Jesus. I thank you for every viewer who has heard this message. I'm declaring authority over them. Restore this authority to the church, to the men of God, to the believers, to the children of God. Release this authority, O God, and confirm it in a mighty and in a great way in their lives. If anyone is going through challenge, I pray that you may deal with it by the power of this authority in the name of Jesus. I speak security, I speak healing, I speak deliverance, I speak new levels of knowledge and understanding. Even those who are not born again, tap them, Lord, convict them to commit their lives to you, that they may love you from today. We thank you, we honor you. In Jesus' name, I do pray and believe. Everybody say amen.